Welcome once again as we discuss some topics on anatomy and physiology. And today we are going to discuss the cell cycle, mitosis, and cytokinesis. So what is the cell cycle? It's actually the cycle from one cell division to the next cell division. We're going to look here. So this cell has just divided into two new cells. There's going to be a cycle where this cell is going to go through some phases until it is ready to divide once again. So this is the cell cycle. What are those phases? We're going to look at them in detail. But to start with, there's the G1, the first gap, the S, the synthesis, G2, the second gap, and then M is actually the mitosis, where the actual division takes place. So we're going to look at each one of these and learn the most important events. We are looking at G1. We call it gap one, or the first gap phase. This is the interval between the cell division and the DNA replication. So we haven't replicated the DNA yet. So what is the cell doing? It's actually growing, maturing, and multiplying all its contents. So now the cell is going to get ready to divide into two cells. It has to double up its cytoplasm. It has to double up all its organelles, the endoplasmic reticulum, the Golgi, and all of those organelles except the chromosomes. They will replicate later on. When it comes to the synthesis phase or the S phase, this is where the centrioles will replicate. So I will make another copy and the chromosomes will replicate. They will make another copy. Let's look at our figure again. This is the G1 phase. When we come to the S phase, the synthesis, each chromosome right here made another copy of itself. This chromosome made another copy of itself. So the original 46 chromosomes, we're going to have them, each one of it replicating, so that when we divide at the end, we have 46 for each new cell. The third phase is the G2 phase. This is the second gap. This is after the DNA has replicated and the cell is not dividing yet. So it's really getting ready and it's making all the enzymes important for cell division. The M phase is the actual mitotic phase. This is where the cell will divide into two. Instead of one nucleus, we will have two nuclei. The cytoplasm will divide and we will have two daughter cells that are going to be formed. So we're going to look at the M phase, the mitosis phase. We're going to look again. It is in different stages. We're going to look at what happens in each of those stages. So mitosis is the cell division. It's actually the division of the nucleus. We're going to look at this in a minute. And cell division will occur in all body cells except the reproductive cells. So if we're talking about muscle cell, liver cell, bone cell, skin cell, all of those cells in the body are going to divide by mitosis except the sperms and the eggs. They're going to divide by a completely different process. This is called meiosis, and we will look at it in a different presentation. Now, why does mitosis occur? First, because of growth. So if there is a baby or a young child, this child has to grow to mature size. So the baby liver has to grow to an adult liver. How does this happen? One liver cell will divide to make two new ones. Each of those two new ones will divide again. So for growth, the same for the bone, is going to divide by mitosis to reach an adult size and so forth. for replacement. So cells die out. The skin is made up of several layers, and the topmost layer eventually dies, and we don't know it, but every time we sleep and we rub against this those bed covers, some of those dead cells slough away, and we need to make new cells. So the deeper layers of the skin will divide by mitosis for the skin to grow back. In repair, so if there is a cut or if there is a surgical incision, how do tissues repair themselves? By a process of mitosis, where they grow back. So mitosis is extremely important for our body. These are the phases of mitosis. We are going to look at them: prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. Let's look at what happens in each of those stages. We need to memorize the different events, and these are the most important. In prophase, the chromatin is no longer in the shape of fibers. It's going to start to condense, and we're going to see actual chromosomes. The centrioles are going to move to opposite poles, and the centrioles are going to create the mitotic spindle. The nuclear membrane is going to start to disappear. In metaphase, the chromosomes that formed over here are now going to line up along the cell equator. We're going to look at the diagram and come back to this. So this is where prophase starts. Let me take you through here. This is the interphase. This is still at the second gap stage. If I look at this cell, we have duplicated the number of chromosomes, but they are in the shape of chromatin fibers. We have two of the centrioles. In prophase, the chromatin will start to condense and take the specific shape of chromosomes. The centrioles are going to start to move away to different poles of the cell, and they will create the mitotic spindle. In metaphase, those chromosomes are going to align to the middle of the cell. We call this the cell equator. We can see already the centrioles have moved to the opposite poles, and the centrioles have created the mitotic spindle, which helps the alignment of those chromosomes. In anaphase, the centromeres, which are holding one pair of chromosomes together, are going to break and split, and now those chromosomes are going to move to opposite sides of the cell. In telophase and cytokinesis, the cytoplasm is going to divide. So cytokinesis is division of the cytoplasm. How does this happen? We're going to see a cleavage furrow starting to appear, and two new cells are going to start forming. Each one is going to have its nuclear membrane. So this is anaphase. The two chromosomes are going to move to different poles. They split. The centromeres have split. This is the telophase and the cytokinesis. This is the furrow, the cleavage furrow. It indicates where the cytoplasm is actually going to divide. We can see that a new nuclear membrane is forming for this cell, another for that cell, and eventually two new daughter cells have been produced. A very important concept to remember in mitosis. We started with a parent cell. This cell is going to divide through those four stages and form two new daughter cells. These two daughter cells are identical to the parent cell in every aspect. So I have 46 chromosomes over here. Each of these will have 46 chromosomes. They will be totally and completely identical. As I said, a liver cell wants to make two more liver cells. A bone cell will make two bone cells, and so forth. We're going to end up by talking about a few facts on mitosis. Now remember, this occurs in all body cells except reproductive gamete cells, but I have one cell in the body that does not have a nucleus, and this cell is the mature red blood cell. So mature RBCs cannot undergo mitosis. They don't have a nucleus. They will age and die away, and then the bone marrow is going to produce newer cells. How many times does a cell divide? Most body cells divide between 40 and 60 times before they eventually die. How long is the cell cycle? Most body cells on average take about 24 hours to divide. There are few very rapidly dividing cells that might have a shorter time, like 10 hours or so, but this is the normal average of a cell cycle. And again, thank you for joining us in the presentation of cell cycle, mitosis, and cytokinesis.